folks in mid-Michigan celebrated the decision today. Shannon Kantner met a few who say this is a day they will never forget.
Doma is dead.
I'm sitting at my desk crying.
I was just overwhelmed.
That's a common feeling among the LGBT community. They say this ruling is long overdue.
This ruling really means a lot for us as a couple, but also as a family. It's really the first time that the federal government is validating us as a family on equal terms as my siblings and other people in our communities.
Kent married his partner Diego in Washington, D.C. last year, but they've been together for 11 years, and their son is 2.5 now. The whole family visited the White House to advocate for LGBT families just a couple of weeks ago.
So this is really the icing on top of that experience.
Kent was monitoring the Supreme Court blog daily, much like Robin Miner Swartz. She's trying to plan for retirement with her partner and is sick of jumping through legal hoops as a same-sex couple.
It's a huge deal for us to know now that we're on that path to maybe not have to go through all those hoops is such a tremendous relief to us.
But they realize there might still be a long path ahead, even though this is a big step forward. Advocacy groups like Equality Michigan say it should be a wake-up call to repeal the state's ban on same-sex marriage.
Today's ruling tells Michigan that we really truly are behind the times, and the time is now or yesterday to catch up and to make sure that LGBT citizens can care for our partners and our families.
And once the initial shock settles in, they'll get back to work.
I haven't cried yet, but I'm fairly certain that I will at some point today.
In Lansing, Shannon Kantner, Fox 47 News.
And those who celebrated the decision today say there is still a lot of work that needs to be done.